trying a new delay there. What are
yes,
you trying?
Yes, our friends Emmy and Yuki there over at Free the Tone sent the new flight time delay to us in mid-tour to check out and just dialing it in. Lots of possibilities and options, so I'm figuring it out. But certainly sounds very cool. Nice compliment, a couple of other delay times to my usual mad professor deep blue delay that stays on most of the time.
You've been using those for a long time, haven't you, the deep
years
blues?
And years and years, yes. So that's like my standard kind of bit of delay. In fact, I got it knocked back a bit too much there, but like you can just hear it.
Just one repeat kind
one
of thing.
One repeat. Just adds a little room sound, I suppose.
So is the flight time, is that like a TC inspired unit?
I think it is. It's going for that more studio sound, but you can put a bit of modulation in and things like that if I change to the other preset I was just working on.
Running that mono tonight because you don't run stereo amps, do you?
I rarely play any stereo, so it's just going back to the two rock being the bulk of the tone, and then this little deluxe of Simon's, yours there behind holding the camera, does a little bit of extra reverb and sparkly stuff for me. Sometimes we mic it, sometimes it doesn't need it in. This is a very lively room we're in tonight.
So you're just using it for a little ambience?
A little extra something.
And some chime?
Yes. And splitting them with the Lila passive splitter back there. So
you've been using that for a long time as well, haven't
years,
you?
Yes, yeah.
Not getting too much reflection.
So the buffer, that's passive, so the buffer in my SOV, in my signature SOV, that drives the splitter, you see, so try and keep those things to a minimum.
Do you think speakers are important to your sound in your 410 cab and like when you use 12-inch speakers?
See, often when listening through a microphone, I like the sound of 12s, but there's something live with this cab, with the Eminence Raging Cajuns in, that it's just really big and fat sounding in the low midway without too much lows, and I like that on stage. So in some ways, it's more of a feel thing, you know, how the guitar feels. So we often record with 12s, but it's more for me, really. So it feels full, it makes the strings physically feel nice and fat under your fingers. And then we've got the pretty little Celestian in the deluxe.
Celestian gold, you can't see that in there, how dark it is, but it takes a bit more power. And pedal board wise, it's still the old favourites on there for overdrive.
Yeah, this is the newest edition, the Royal Blue.
That's from Mad Professor again.
Yeah, my mate Harry over there, good man. And I've been really digging that because it does this cool thing, right? So if I play with the guitar turned down, as I often do, I have a solo with it on like 7 or 8 or something. By the nature of, you know, single coil pickups, it gets a bit darker when you turn it down to like 7 or 8. And if you put that on and then turn it down to about 6.
Oh yeah, it like extends the high end.
Yeah, the old fuzz face pedals used to do that. So you have to go into it first, so that's why I'm going in before my SOV.
Yeah.
So it's just basically off this, that's just a junction box to plug into. And the tune is true bypass, so this is C in the pickups. So you get that nice sparkly.
It almost sounds like a buffer, but there's a little bit of drive there as well.
So that would be like this without that.
Sounding actually.
Yeah, which is, but it's also a useful tone, and I'll use that if I want to be more
like it's just rolling
jazzy sounding.
Yeah, rolling some tone off without actually rolling some tone off.
I've really been digging that pedal because of that. And then I've my SOV being my classic bridge pickup.
Sound in the SOV,
woody,
isn't it?
Yes, nice and thick, kind of almost like a bit of marshalliness in there. Everybody thinks of it as a Dumbly pedal, but which has got some of that articulation. But to me, it's does a good, you know, you can, if you turn the tone down on the guitar, you can get that Eric Johnson kind of thing, which I can't really play. But
that's the misconception with the whole Dumble thing, is that it's actually more of a touch sensitivity rather than a tone.
Yeah, and that...
when you feel it and feel the note under your fingers as opposed to just hearing it.
That's the whole thing with this pedal for me, is the...
Guitar-wise on this tour, same guitar you've been using for a bit there.
Yeah, this one's been about 18 months now, I think. It's got some natural wear and tear on it, and some you helped it on its way a little bit.
Yeah, but, bedding in nicely.
Some real stuff. That's, you know, a few hundred gigs on that one now, driving around. So the usual. Did that little tweak for me, so this doesn't do anything anymore. Because I never use it, so the only...
Is it neck pickups out of the tone circuit altogether?
Everything apart from that, right?
Yep.
So that usually lives on about 7 or 8. Just takes the edge off, and then now you get much clearer. Because it loads it down, right? So, there's that, and the new one over here, which is similar. What's the difference? The neck is a...
It's a flat sawn. And it's a 9.5-inch radius all the way on that one, just
right.
To see how we go.
Yeah.
59 reserves in there, and again, the neck pickup is completely out of the circuit.
So the same pickups in both guitars.
Yeah.
Right? They sound noticeably different flavours, I'd say.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, they both sound like...
I mean, I think this one sounds... It's got that real Stevie slow blues thing going.
Yeah.
For whatever reason,
sounds
I do
like
not know.
A green strap with a rosewood neck is supposed to sound like.
This one sounds like a Sunburst guitar, doesn't it?
A little darker in there.
Let's hear some clean playing with the delay then, because that's.
Well, I was trying to dial it in for.
Gig, Matt.